Remember, with great power comes great responsibility. And apparently other Spider-Mans as well. Back to another Reputize video, guys. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse revolves around a teen named Miles Morales, who becomes Spider-Man of his reality, crossing his path with five other counterparts from other dimensions to stop a threat for all realities. As you can tell by the story synopsis, this revolves around another one of those alternate dimension universe type stories. So basically, you got our dimension, which is where our beloved Spider-Man comes from. Then you got this, which is where Gwen Stacy's from. Then there's this pig, who's also a spider pig. And then this 1930s gangster-like Spider-Man. And you got all these other different characters that intertwine and tries to take down the Kingpin. It was very interesting. I was very hesitant. I don't know why it took me this long to review this movie, so I apologize about that, guys. But this was very interesting. A friend of mine let me borrow his copy on Blu-ray, so I'm glad he persisted on me wanting to do this review because I actually enjoyed it. I just got done watching it on the big screen up front, the surround sound on, with the little puppies beside my lap. So, getting to the positives, the animation was just astounding. I don't usually go for animated movies. Anybody who knows me knows that. But this one, I actually enjoyed. It was a different kind of animation. It's kind of hard to explain. It's like one of those animations that's, it has like splotches in it. It's not like a cartoon like South Park or Bugs Bunny or anything like that. Or it's not anything animated like Wreck-It Ralph or The Incredibles. It is of its own. And I thought that was really unique. It was something original. And you get a lot of, you know, good messages in it, just like you would in a regular Spider-Man. This revolved all around Spider-Man, but the different stories of Spider-Man. It actually shows the comic books as well, thrown in there to, you know, just so you could get the sense of, okay, we're watching a movie of several different stories coming together. So that's basically what it was. The cinematography and lighting and, like I said, the animation all goes hand in hand. It was really excellent. The coloring was just fantastic. The music, all of that. I really enjoyed it. You're watching a YouTuber that doesn't really go for animated movies that much, which says a lot. Like I said, there was a lot of heartfelt moments. This kid, Miles Morales, goes through this life-altering scenario where he becomes Spider-Man, meets these others, and he tries to learn, and he tries to, you know, getting good with his pops, who is a cop. He just goes through a lot. The story was really good. I liked where they were going. I have never heard the story of Gwen Stacy, Spider-Gwen. And as far as those other characters, the only story of Peter Parker I know is Spider-Man and the Amazing Spider-Man, which that was also thrown into. It had a really great cast. Shameik Moore, who played Miles Morales, the main character. Jake Johnson, who plays Peter B. Parker, that came from the Amazing Spider-Man universe. He also played in Tag a couple years back, and I think he's a really good actor. He did a really wonderful job voicing his part. All the cast members, Nicolas Cage, he played the 1930s version of Spider-Man with the look like Dark Man. All of the cast in this did a really terrific job. The characters are just really great. You have Kingpin, who's mainly the main villain. He looks like Humpty Dumpty, pretty much. And some of the other parts where they were dealing with Jason and all that, since this was an animated movie, it was like off the rails, and it did make me chuckle, I admit. And you also have the likes of Doc Ock. Not the Doc Ock that most people know of. It's Doc Ock's wife. She's one of the villains as well, and I thought she did a really good job. I really don't have that much negative to say about it. It was a pretty fun ride. I didn't find myself bored in it. I didn't fall asleep, which is a really good sign. Don't do that for most movies, but still. I'm going to give Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse an A. Thank you for watching this video. I really do appreciate it. Like, subscribe, get reputized, share. What did you think of Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Leave me a comment down below and let me know what you think. Stay tuned for more videos and reviews coming soon. And as always, thank you so much for watching. And if you like this, you can click right here and get reputized.